next questions are from Cloudfang LP. First question is, what would you do for a contact bar? To be completely honest, I saw this question coming. There's also another question that I saw coming, and I know somebody asked it, and I just forget who. But, I don't know. I'm not really the biggest fan of Klondikes, to be completely honest. I don't know what I would do for that. They've never really appealed to me that much. I don't know. Whoa. Oh. Sorry, somebody was sending me a file on Skype. I don't know what for or where. Anyway. Clawfang LP also asks, do you plan on going to college? If so, what for? At the moment, I'm still trying to figure it out, but I won't deny that I will be going to college, and I won't deny that I won't be. But if what for, I'm still working on that, too. I don't know, probably something in the graphic-y art field or something. Some kind of art field, I'm sure. But yeah, I probably might that. I'll say I might be going to college. I'm gonna think about it. There's still plenty of time to think about these kind of things. I mean, I know I'm in a senior year, but I don't have to make decisions immediately, or so I've been told, but I don't know. I don't know what I want to be when I grow up. Anyway, next questions are from Cool Testify. Their first question is, do you have tips for an LPer who wants more subs? Well, I kind of have two answers on this one. One, if you're LPing only to get more subs, like if that's your only goal, then can't really help you. But if you mean like more subs as in, you know, gaining a bigger audience without, you know, completely being obsessed by the number, then I would say reach out in the LPing community some. Talk to people, you know, find friends that like, you know, games that you like. Just basically work on your interests and see how many people out there, you know, like the same thing. Odds are there's probably a bunch. But choose your friends well. Like, you don't want to find friends that are like, you know, really mean other people and force you to do things. Because I've had that in real life. I haven't had any experience with that on YouTube, but I know it's probably possible. And just, you know, find a good pack of friends. Everybody has a friend out there somewhere. You just gotta find them. And in turn, I think that would probably help you, you know, gain a bigger audience. I mean, you know, you make more friends and, you know, you help each other grow and experience. And, you know, I guess the subs just kind of come, I guess. To be completely honest, I don't know where most of my subs came from, but they just kind of appeared, and I'm like, okay, cool. And I really do appreciate every single view and, you know, sub I get, so. But I have seen people get a little obsessed over subs, and I don't think it's something to be, you know, completely worried about, but subs are nice, and having an audience is nice, but it's not the most important thing in the world. Second question from Cool Testify. If you don't have any advice, how did you get so popular? To be completely honest, I really don't think I'm that popular. There's a lot higher LPers out there that are way more popular than me, and like I said, LPing isn't a popularity contest. You just go out there, have fun, and if the subs come, they come. If they don't, so what? Just keep having fun with it. Or, you know, if you don't want to LP anymore, I'm sure there's a lot of stuff out there that people can do. You know, like there's a bunch of hobbies. Like I said, this is mainly a hobby for me, so. Okay, next questions are from SGG Gamer. They ask, I'm not exactly sure how to answer this question. If you had to work at Burger King and make a song about it, what would it be? Wow, you're gonna make me really be creative on this one. I don't know what the song would be, to be honest. I was going to say something along the lines of Bingo, but I couldn't come up with any catchy tunes. I was gonna say I'm not a really good, like, song maker, like Frontal Boss and other people like that, so I don't know. And their other question is, do you plan on doing any co-op LPs? You might just have to wait and see. I won't deny it, and I won't say yes. So, yeah. You just gotta wait and see what the future holds. Heck, even I don't know some of my next LPs, so... just gotta see. Okay, next question is from... Sakuno 20... Is from Sakuno 1221. Their question is, what tips do you have for those that want to start making LPs? Okay, let's see. I already said be yourself. My next tip would be, besides be yourself, come up with a commentary style that fits you. Like, you want to be a more serious, informative gamer, but, you know, still have your funny moments? Do you want to be more of a comedic commentator? It's more or less up to you. But yeah, like I said, I would say, besides be yourself, come up with a commentary style that fits your own unique preferences. Their other question is, what's your favorite game of all time? Like I said before in previous questions, I don't know if I can answer that. There's too many great games. Okay, next questions are from WeHero97. They ask, what is your favorite game genre? I will admit I'm a fan of action games. I'm also a fan of adventure games like Zelda. Is Zelda being action? I guess Zelda would be action-adventure. But I also like RPGs a lot. You know, Kingdom Hearts is an RPG. I like the Mario RPGs. I like a lot of unsung RPGs, like I'm looking into getting... Yes, GT, I'm looking into getting Artanelico and a couple, and Monocamia. Because those interest me. So yeah, I do like RPGs, but my favorite game genre would probably be RPG. I just have a bigger history with them than I do action adventures or action or platformers or all that, any of that other stuff. So I'll just go with RPG. And since RPG is such a big area, if you can, I don't know, to each your own, I guess. I don't really have a very favorite type of RPG. Getting some water again, so hold on. The next question comes from Yonin777. Who are your top three inspirations that got you LPing? Chugga Conroy, Super Skarmory, Nintendo Capri Sun. I'm sorry if that sounds pretty, you know, usual and generic, but I can't lie, those are my inspirations. Like I said, there were a lot more, but if I had to pick a top three, those would probably be it. I'm not saying in any particular order, but those are probably the top three. Second question. Do you think PS3 is better than Xbox 360 or equal to it? Considering I have neither, I can't say. But I will say this, I'm sure the Xbox expands on areas where the PS3 does not, and I'm sure the PS3 expands in areas that the Xbox 360 doesn't. I'm sure each have their own qualities and aspects that make them pretty good gaming systems. Of course, like I said, I can't really say, but that's just all I'm gonna say on that matter. The Mario Hot Sauce asks, what is your favorite Kingdom Hearts game? Like I said before, Birth by Sleep, hands down, is a question. Okay. And he also asked, and this actually piqued my interest. They also asked, I'm sorry. Would you ever consider doing a weekly thing when you pick a random subber and play an online game with them, like a Little Big Planet Brawl or anything like that? I'll admit, when I saw this question, I thought about it, and I'm still thinking about it, so I'll keep you guys posted on that one, to be honest. I will. But like I said, I'm not exactly ready to give out my Brawl code yet, and, you know, Skype and all that stuff, but it's a thought for the future. Okay, next up is a question from... I don't know how to pronounce this whatsoever. I think it says dead, but the E is a 3. The E is a 3 again. Cause 23. I'm sorry if I really butchered up your name, I know, but I don't know. I kind of had a little trouble reading it, I'm sorry. they ask, do you plan to do sequels to Paper Mario, Super Paper Mario, or Thousand Year Door? It's a possibility. Like I said, if you ever, like, if you guys ask about, like, what's the future LPs, I will not give a straight answer. I'm just gonna say it could happen and it might not happen, because that's the honest truth. You just gotta wait and see, because I like my LPs to be a surprise. Maybe I'll get to the point one day where I just reveal all my LPs that I'm going to do in my LPing career at one time, but I don't plan to do that for a long time, so I kind of like the element of surprise. Excuse me. They also ask, what's your favorite Pokemon or Pokemon game? Oh, my favorite Pokemon game would probably be up there with, Heart Gold and Emerald. I have played Crystal, but I played it after Heart Gold, and yeah. I mean, Crystal's great, and I like it, but I just kind of liked Heart Gold a little bit more, but... I don't know, I like Heart Gold a little bit better than Emerald, but Emerald's pretty far up there, too. Also, Platinum's good. And another favorite Pokemon I gotta pick. Let's go with Vulpix. Vulpix is an adorable fire type, and although it kind of got chipped in every single gen except the first one, it's pretty good. Especially Ninetales. Ninetales looks amazing. Starting to lose my voice here. Aha! Next question from CattyDoll409, aka Stormy. I added in the aka myself. She asks, where did you get the name The Lightning Spirit 78? Like I said, Stormy, in this call the other night, I warned you it was going to be a boring answer, and the thing is, I just kind of came up with it. No rhyme or reason. I do like lightning. It's one of my favorite elements, you know, as far as fire, wind, and ice, and all that stuff is concerned. 78 was a random number that came out of my head, and spirit sounded cool. So I guess I'll go with that. She also asks, if you could get any game in the world, what game would you get? Skyward Sword, because I could play it before anybody else. Either that or Kingdom Hearts 3, if they're finished developing it, but I highly, highly doubt that. Anyway, next question is from Npreested. Like I said, I'm really sorry if I butcher these names. I really do apologize. They ask, what is your favorite game? I think I've gone through a whole list of this one before. If you want to find out, look below. And by... look below? What? Go back to previous parts. I think I've elaborated on this a little bit. They also ask, I was thinking about starting my own Let's Plays for the first time, so could you give me some tips? Well, like I said, I've given you guys tips on being yourself, and I've given you guys tips on your own commentary style, so now I guess I can talk about game choice. Game choice, I think, is probably one of the most crucial aspects of LPing. I've seen it in action. Underrated games do get a lot of less views than games such as Mario or Zelda. However, that's only to be taken into consideration if you absolutely care about the views and the subs and that kind of stuff. If you don't care about this kind of stuff, like me, then take into consideration games that you like, be they mainstream or not. For instance, a good non-mainstream game would probably be something from, let's take a GT's LP for example, Artanelica. He has the first Artanelica LP on YouTube. So, yeah, that's a very underrated game right there. But he's doing it because he likes the game and he wanted to LP it, so he didn't care about that kind of stuff, and yeah, he's just LPing it anyway. But if you are more of a fan of mainstream, then who's stopping you? If you like Zelda, go with Zelda. Go with Twilight Princess, or maybe Minish Cap, or heck, maybe you like Link's Awakening. Or maybe you like Mario games. Go with Super Mario World, or Mario 3, or Galaxy. There's a lot of games for you to choose from. And basically, I've seen it's pretty impossible to be completely original in game choice, because odds are, if there's a game out there, lately I've seen from day one, it has an LP on YouTube. Unless it's so underrated and so minuscule and so bad that no one has ever played it. So, yeah, that's all I can tell you on that one. More or less, it's up to personal preference. Go with your gut. What game are you most comfortable in commentating about? What game do you know the most about? What games do you love the most? What games do you want to show the public? And just go from there. And I spent so long talking about that I lost my train of thought here. Where was I? There we go. There's the next question. Jacket Kong asks, what's your favorite thing to watch on YouTube besides Let's Plays? Probably anime. I do like to watch a lot of anime so I can, you know, learn from them and, like, start drawing better anime stuff. By anime, I mean manga, but I also like to watch a few popular things, like Is Gonna Need a Microwave This? And stuff like that. Niga Higa I watch sometimes when they come out with new stuff. I guess that's about it. My friends are constantly sending me random stuff, so, like Charlie the Unicorn and things like that, so I've seen those, and yeah. And they also ask, what's your favorite character from the Mario series? Well, I did answer what my favorite species was earlier, the Yoshis and Luma, so I guess I could give another character. Probably, I could go with maybe Rosalina. Rosalina was a cool character. She actually had a character development whatsoever, but she did have a backstory. Or maybe she did have character development. I don't know. I gotta think about that one, but I'll go with Rosalina. She was cool. That and that little black Luma that I always thought sounded British. Or maybe Australian. Either way, it had an accent to me.